Israelis are protesting and scuffling at the gates of the shadowy facility SDE Teiman prison in the Negev desert. They are opposing the detention of 9 soldiers accused of torturing a Gaza prisoner. In response to the allegations, Israel's military had launched an investigation and took the accused personnel for questioning. The demonstrators rioted and chanted shame and waved Israeli national flags opposing the move. The detention of soldiers also prompted an outcry among members of Israel's far-right government. It is understood that the Palestinian detainee abused by the IDF was admitted to a hospital following severe injuries that rendered him incapable of walking. Several reports by rights groups, including an investigation by the Associated Press, have emerged outlining the cases of severe abuses inflicted on the Palestinian detainees at the notorious facility. A petition was filed at Israel's Supreme Court by an Israeli human rights organization. It points that tens of thousands of languishing prisoners from the Gaza enclave, including women, children, elderly, and medics, are being subjected to brutal torture. They face physical assault, starvation, and neglect in Israel's military prison cells. It adds that in recent months, dozens of Palestinian detainees are in deteriorating health conditions and have been released from the Israeli cell bearing visible scars indicating torture. The Israeli military, however, denies ill treatment of Palestinians. IDF insists that it acts according to the international law and those arrested get access to food, medicine, water and clothing. The claim, however, has been contested by domestic and international rights organizations. A United Nations Agency for Palestinian Refugees, or the UNRWA, report released in April alleged that some of its staff members detained by Israel were subjected to severe beatings, humiliation, insults, ill treatment, and were, quote, forced to strip naked. They were subjected to different forms of abuse. Some of them waterboarding and faced threats of rape and electrocution. UNRWA documented the release of 1,506 detainees from Gaza that included 43 kids and 84 women via the Kerem Shalom crossing. It said that they were, and I quote, made to act like animals or got urinated on, tortured with loud music and noise, were subjected to deprivation of water, food, sleep and toilets, suffered due to prolonged use of tightly locked handcuffs, causing open wounds and friction injuries. The U.S. expressed deep concerns about the report and pressed Israel to launch an official probe to hold the perpetrators accountable. Since then, Israel has resorted to transferring the bulk of Palestinian detainees from the SDE Teiman to other facilities. Tel Aviv is facing international condemnation for its continued brutal offensive in Gaza that killed 39,360 civilians and has injured 90,900 others. Due to the carpet bombing, vast tracts of the enclave lies in ruins as civilians struggle to survive amid the crippling humanitarian aid blockade. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu stands accused of genocide at the International Criminal Court and flouting the court's ruling that ordered immediate cessation of hostilities months ago. For all the latest news, download the WION app and subscribe to our YouTube channel.